How's everyone doing? Good to see you all. Has everyone had a nice day? I just seem to be spending so much time on this computer, but it's a necessary evil, isn't it, to try build a business. What's everyone else been up to? Who have we got in the comments? Well done, Imi. First place. Great work. Michael, how you doing? James, how you doing, mate? Good to see you. Hi, Amy. Fancy seeing you here. It's been a while. Michael again. Michael Cope, how you doing, mate? Good to see you. Maggie. My mum. Brilliant. Some people on Facebook as well. On multiple devices. Good to see everyone. Nice. So I'm looking forward to tonight because we've got Tom P on the show again tonight. And he is probably the busiest musician in the world right now. He's just putting out so many new songs and been extremely creative, which is awesome. So I'm going to start off a cover. I'm going to play a few songs tonight, I think. I'm going to do... We were talking in the in soundcheck earlier on today. Sorry, I was just reading the comments then about instant disqualification. Yep, James. Didn't even mention it. You're that disqualified. I think we're just going to just have a bit of a laugh tonight and just see where the night goes and potentially play some classic pop punk. I don't think that's going to happen. I don't know. Who knows? Who knows, viewers? Should I start on an original, a cover? What do you want? Thanks. Thanks, Jake. Appreciate that. You're not half bad yourself. I'm going to do a cover to start with. You're going to have to bear with me because I'm doing this whole loopy thing. Let's see what happens. Keep getting texts and messages from people and it's really throwing me off. Upside down, I'll be the bad guy now, but no, I ain't too proud. I couldn't be there, even if I tried. You don't believe it, you every time. Seasons change and our love went cold. Feed the flame cause I can't let go. It's time that we should let it all go. I say so. I knew that this was doomed from the get-go. You thought that it was special, special, but it was just the sex though, sex though. And then only the echoes, echo. I think it's time that we should let it all go. Seasons changed and our love went cold. Feed the flame cause I can't let go. Run away, but we're running in circles. Run away, run away. I dare you to do something. I'm waiting on you again. So won't you take the play? Run away, but we're running in circles. Run away, run away. There we go. I guess that's a thing now. I'm still learning the whole looping thing. It's quite new territory for me, so bear with me. And I haven't quite even got a real looping station yet. I'm just using this microphone and putting it to the guitar, and that's about as far as it goes. But I still enjoyed doing it. It's good fun. I enjoy doing the whole looping thing. But it's quite nerve-wracking because once you get started, you just got to go with it, see what happens. So what we got going on? Dancing with the dog. That's funny. Casper's loving this. Phil's in the house. Mate, I haven't seen you in ages. You should definitely come on the show. In fact, I will drop you a message real soon, man, and let's get you on here. I hope you're still playing music. What else we got going on? Paula. Well, last time, Paula, I played Biffy Clyro for you, and I think you may have left the stream, which is fine. Obviously, you may have had something else to do, but we'll see how we're getting on for time. But yes, it's a potential. Right, I'm just going to jump right into introducing you to tonight's guest. Let's go. Huge round of applause for Tom, everyone. Woo! And the crowd goes wild. How are you doing, man?
I'm good, mate.
Thank you so much for joining me again, mate.
No, it's cool. A bit last minute, but
I'm good, thank you.
I think the last minute things are the best. Maybe.
It's me, mate. I'm terrible. But yeah, mate, it's I'm looking forward to seeing what you got. I put together the Spotify playlist for the Assembly Point guests today, actually, and I was blasting out your Spotify during that.
Nice.
It was incredible. You've got some absolute bangers, mate, and such an array of styles as well. It's just like you've got proper lovely little like ballady kind of acoustic-y songs that feel really nice, and then next you go into like a more rockier kind of punkier kind of vibe. Just ace how eclectic your taste is. It's really good.
Oh, thank you, mate. I'm never sure if that's like a good or a bad thing, because if you look at yourself as like an artist or a brand, if you like, is it confusing if you do too much? I think it probably is, isn't it? But that leads on quite well.
I think to a certain degree it is, but I think at the end of the day, it's about doing what you're happy doing, isn't it?
Yeah, man, definitely. If you're making music and you're loving doing it, then cool.
Well, that's
yeah,
it.
Leads on quite nicely.
So,
when we had this last time, loads of writing.
Oh yeah,
as much as possible, really. But when we did this,
mate, the latency on this is insane.
Is it right? Sorry. So when we did this last time,
no, it's me. I'm interrupting you. Again.
Right, I'm gonna.
I've
talk,
just done it again.
We're ready. Ready. I'm gonna talk. I'll do it. I'll do it now. Yeah. So when we had this chat the first time round, we were talking about old pop punk, and at the same time, there's a guy called Chris Aspin that I've been in bands with since I was like 16 or 17, and we came up like with the same things like early Blink. Alkaline Trio, all the stuff that we talked about, and we've been on about writing for a while, so we started this little collaborative project, and we've just been writing pop punk songs, just like old school, and it's a bit of a collaborative
Tom,
thing. Yes,
I'm gonna have to interrupt you.
Okay.
You need to turn your microphone up.
Is
it's
better?
Fine for me, but apparently in the comments people are saying, oh yeah, that's way better.
Right, so basically...
Just chime in the comments if that's good.
Yeah.
As you were, mate, sorry.
It's all right. Yeah, so I started writing loads of pop punk with a friend that I've been in bands with growing up. And it's turned into a bit of a collaborative thing, so it'd be wicked to get you on a track.
Oh, yes, mate. I'd love that.
So I know you said you're a busy boy.
I am.
But when... You are slightly less busy. Let's do a writing session.
Oh, mate, I would love that. 100%. That'd be so good. Just to be clear, there is a weird latency. I don't know if it's the same for people in the audience, but or people watching us, but there's a huge delay. Maybe it'd be worthwhile. If you want to play a song and then maybe leave the chat after and then rejoin it and see if that improves the latency.
Were you talking to me then?
Yes.
I wonder how long it actually took on the video. I love it. It's like 50% of this is going to be silence.
That's what I'm saying. So I think you should play a song.
Leave and come back.
And then come back and hopefully that'll improve it. But I really want to just have a song from you first before you go, all just right. In case this is the last time I ever see you.
Yeah,
it may go off forever. Oh, God.
We'll get there.
It's all right. We're not live or anything. It's fine.
Are you regretting asking me last minute now?
Nobody on the road, nobody on the beach. I feel it in the air, the summer's out of reach. Empty lane, empty street, sun goes down alone. I'm driving by your house, though I know you're not home. And I can see you, your brown skin shining in the sun. Got your hair combed back and your sunglasses on, baby. And I can tell you my love for you, it will still be strong after the boys of summer have gone. Never will forget those nights. I wonder if it was a dream. Remember how you made me crazy? Remember how I made you scream? No, I don't understand what happened to our love. But baby, when I get you back, I'm gonna show you what I'm made of. And I can see you, your brown skin shining in the sun. I see you walking real slow and you're smiling at everyone. And I can tell you my love for you, it will still be strong after the parties of summer have gone. Out on the road today I saw a black flag sticker on a Cadillac. Little voice inside my head said, don't look back, you can never look back. I thought I knew what love was, what did I know? Those days are gone forever, I should just let them go. But I can see you, your brown skin shining in the sun. You got your top put down, lady, your warm baby. I can tell you my love for you, it will still be strong after the fires of summer have gone. I can see you, your brown skin shining in the sun. You got your head slipped back and your wayfarers on, baby. And I can tell you my love for you, it will still be strong.
Yeah! Woo!
Pop punk classics. I don't know if it's Don Henley, but Ataris.
The Ataris, man. Wow. Love it.
Cool. So I'm going to leave then.
I think you should just head out. I'm going to play a song and then come back and then I'll rejoin you. But I think there's some weird latency thing going on with us too. And it's taken about 16 days for us to answer each other. All right. I'll see you back in a few seconds. All right. Okay, I'm going to play an original song. So I had an email from somebody and they requested a song. It's their 30th anniversary. It's Tracy and Michael. I'm happy to do shout outs for anyone if you want to drop me an email and that sort of stuff. But especially I just want to say thank you to these guys. They've watched every single episode. They've been in the comments, commenting every single time, and you know they've supported the channel no end, and I'm genuinely like grateful for that. So happy anniversary, guys! 30 years, which is incredible. And they asked me to play my new original song, which is extremely kind of them. So I'm going to jump into that.
I'm gonna start again. Just a practice. Thank you.
And I know my body and my soul ain't working right. Cause I don't wanna know anybody and I wanna stay inside. That's not who I am now, that's not what I want. Lately I've been thinking I want so much more. And so it is, keep things simple, smile and be grateful, and know that everything's gonna be alright. If this ain't living, then I don't know what is. Just know that everything's gonna be just fine. And while your eyes don't wanna be divided by who I used to be, who I used to be. And I know my body and my soul ain't working right. Cause I don't wanna own anybody and I wanna stay inside. I'm just sick of coasting, I just need a rest. Lately I've been thinking it's all inside my head. And so it is, and keep things simple, smile and be grateful, and know that everything's gonna be alright. If this ain't living, then I don't know what is. Just know that everything's gonna be just fine. And why do eyes don't wanna be divided by how I used to see, who I used to be. Who I used to be. And I know my body and my soul ain't working right. Cause I don't wanna know anybody and I wanna stay inside. That's not who I am now, that's not what I want. Lately I've been thinking I want so much more. And so it is, keep things simple, smile and be grateful, and know that everything's gonna be alright. This ain't living, then I don't know what is. Just know that everything's gonna be just fine. And why do eyes don't wanna be divided by who I used to see, who I used to be, who I used to be, who I used to be, who I used to be. Thank you, Wembley. Cheers. That was fun. I tried. I did my best. Happy anniversary, Tracy and Michael. Thank you so much for supporting me every night and coming down, and congratulations on your 30th. Okay, Tom's back. Let's bring him on. Come on, say that it's better.
Yo.
No. It's no better.
We'll just have to try and make do then, man.
That's absolutely fine. So, what did you have in mind for tonight? What were you going to play?
No idea. We had the chat about the pop punk, and so I think I'm just going to play some songs that I like, that hopefully you recognise and everybody else enjoys as well.
That'd be cool. Definitely. Do you want to play another tune and then... We'll just try battle through a bit of a conversation, but I think it's going to be a little bit difficult with this weird timing thing.
Yes, we'll give it a go.
We need like a signal. You okay?
I was just thinking of some sort of signal that I could bring in.
Are you gonna live your life wondering, standing in the back, looking around? Are you gonna waste your time thinking of how you've grown up or how you've missed out? Things are never gonna be the way you want. When's it gonna get you acting serious? Things are never gonna be quite what you want. Or even at 25, you gotta start some time. I'm on my feet, I'm on the floor, I'm good to go. Now all I need is just to hear a song I know. I wanna always feel like part of this was mine. I wanna fall in love tonight. Are you gonna live your life standing in the back looking around? Are you gonna waste your time? You gotta make a move before you miss out. All about stick around, nostalgia won't let you down. Someone's gonna ask you what it's all about, what you're gonna have to say for yourself. I'm on my feet, I'm on the floor, I'm good to go. And all I need is just to hear a song I know. I wanna always feel like part of this was mine. I wanna fall in love tonight. Crimson and clover. Stop my rock and roll high. I'm on my feet, I'm on the floor, I'm good to go. So come on baby, sing me something that I know. I wanna always feel like part of this was mine. I wanna fall in love tonight. I wanna fall in love tonight. I wanna always feel like part of this was mine. I wanna fall in love tonight. I wanna fall in love tonight. I wanna fall in love tonight.
Yeah, mate. Bit of Jimmy Eat World, right?
Yeah, man. That's an old album
now as well.
Yeah, yeah. Right. So do you want to take the reverb off your microphone? And I've got a few questions for you. And usually I would probably chime in and interrupt people at the best of times. But right now, obviously, we've got this latency issue. So I'm going to ask you the question and then I'm just going to let you answer it. And I'm not going to sort of chime in. Okay. Okay, so here's the first question. Where have they gone? What song do you What song do you wish you had have written? That's not the words.
Pretty much anything off Revolutions Per Minute by Rise Against. I love that album, man. That got me into like just that style of pop punk and that style of just music. Like they just it's fast paced and it is quite maybe aggressive in parts, but like there's no fat on it. Like the songs are just there. Like the hooks are there. Everything's there. You can make every one of them into a pop song. So I'd say anything off Revolutions Per Minute by Rise Against.
It is an absolute banger of an album, and also like you say, it's got that the energy and the drive of for what you want in that genre, but if you were to strip it right back, the songs still stand up.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, I quite agree. Next question. This is going to be quite formula because we will keep interrupting each other otherwise. Here we go. Who is your favourite vocalist?
Oof. Chris Carrabba from Dashboard Confessional. He's not necessarily like the best technically, but he's just like, there's something about his delivery when he's on it. I went to see him last year, or maybe the year before. The blurring now. As you get older, they blur. But unbelievable, man. Just 2 hours and he was just on it. It was ace, man. So yeah, Chris Carrabba, 100%.
You see, if you hadn't have said Dashboard Confessional, I wouldn't have known who you meant. But as soon as you said Dashboard Confessional, I was like, oh man, he's got a set of lungs on him. There's the MTV live album that they did, which is unreal. The acoustic Unplugged. Have you heard that?
Yeah, there's no point in singing. It's just the crowd.
I think it's incredible when his voice is absolutely at its peak and he's like, you know, it's. I love that, almost the imperfection when his voice is breaking. It just sounds ace.
Yeah, man. And he's one of the few people that's like survived that emo period, because it were like early 2000s, but he's still going. He's still going. It's impressive, man.
I think they went away for a little while, but they're definitely going strong now, aren't they?
Yeah, they had an album called Crooked Shadows in like 2018. It took a little bit of getting used to, but it's a wicked album. Again, just like full of just bangers. But yeah, I hope they keep making stuff.
Yeah, me too, man. Next question, you ready? Do you remember how it felt after you'd written your first song? And that's a question to both of us.
That's a good question.
It is.
I think probably no, but I reckon I reckon I was incredibly happy until I wrote the second one, and then I realized how bad the first one was. So I think you go through like a process of writing that you get a little bit better every time, but you start out just, it's not even always terrible, but like some of the simplest stuff is the best. So if you've got like three chords, a hook, and a lyric that resonates with you and can resonate with other people, that's like the basis of most good songs, unless you're talking like instrumental prog or mathcore or something like that. So I think that there's probably some early songs that we both wrote that we didn't realize how good they were at the time. Mm. But I reckon I was ashamed of my first song at some point pretty soon after writing it.
I remember, basically, I remember writing my first song and then showing it to my dad. And it was more of a question of him questioning where I was born, because I sounded so American. He was like, you are not Tom DeLonge. I was literally, he was like, you're from Leeds, Matt. You're not from California.
Yeah, well, I've got some cringy first EPs from a band when I was like 17 or 18 that it's way too American. But you're a result of your influences, aren't you?
100%.
I suppose.
Yeah, man. I used to have a song, because me and Joe, before the Dunwells was a thing, me and Joe used to be in a band together called Contagious. And it was basically just a Blink-182 rip-off band. And we used to do like little garden shows with for our neighbours and stuff, like locally. And we'd rock up with like a marquee tent and set our amps up, and we literally wouldn't have enough gear to be able to actually see the show through. But we would do our absolute damned best to like set up as much gear as we could. And we would just be noisy, fast, punk. And I always wanted to be Tom DeLonge, but my vocal range was never there. So I was more like Mark Hoppus, which is fine. But I always really put that American twang. Like it's like turning auto tune up to 100. I turned the American up to 100.
You know, the range gets better with an American accent, though. I think they've got like an advantage straight away. They can put everything in the nose.
It's because they don't say words like, what's that? I miss you song, Tom DeLonge. He says something about, Don't waste your time on me. You're already the voice inside my head. And he doesn't say head, but he goes,
yeah.
Yet.
It's my head.
Yeah. My head.
Yeah, that's
and that's
it.
What I saw a really funny meme, actually. And it was a picture of Tom DeLonge's face, like, faded out in the clouds. And it was like, due to, like, yes. coronavirus, we've seen a sighting of Moyed for the first time or something like that.
Yeah, well, he became just an absolute caricature of himself.
I think he knows it.
Yeah. I think he's probably got, well, he had enough money before all the CIA stuff to not care about it, I think.
Yeah. Absolutely. Right, I'll get another question to you, mate. So I guess this is a question because you've got a few guitars behind you as well. Sorry, Alexa's trying to chime in again. What is your guitar of choice if you are just hanging out with your friends and playing just for fun?
This one.
unless I'm reading the question wrong. What is your guitar of choice if you are hanging out with friends?
Oh, it's just appeared on mine now. Yeah, I think probably the friends are more important than guitar in that sense. But it's a good question. It's definitely a good question. I'm not that much of a techie guy, I suppose, in a lot of ways. Like my dad gave me this, and it's like £150 Tanglewood, but it plays like an electric. And it sounds like a guitar, and I think if you're going in depth with recording and stuff like that. So I've got a Telecaster that I've put some EMGs in right there, and that's ace for recording because it's like a chameleon. And then there's an 8-string. Where is it? There, which is great if you can't be bothered to play bass. You can sort of do it all in one.
You're one of those rare guitarists that play the wrong way around, though. So it must be hard for you to find a guitar that does what you need it to do.
It's expensive.
My guitar of choice is this one. This is just Attack, and I play it. I've played it for years. I've played it to death. And it was originally Joe's. And when I first started City of Lights, I decided that I wanted to do more acoustic-y, kind of rockier stuff. And then I think Joe maybe swapped it for a better, maybe a Taylor or something with my dad. And then whenever my dad seems to inherit another guitar from somewhere, whether it be a friend or one of us or a charity shop or something like that, I always seem to be lurking around the corner waiting to steal it from him.
Mate, we've got that in common.
That's quite funny. He's always like, no, you're not having it. I'm like, next minute, I'm sat on live with it.
You gotta love that. I borrowed my dad's Martin because I've never played a Martin before, but I love them. And I don't play it anymore because I'm not going to want to play anything else ever. So he's spending half of his time in a case. But the beautiful things, man.
Yeah, man, absolutely. It's funny, Steve's just said that as my guitar got woodworm.
Is that from excessive picking?
Yeah. Not of the nose, of plectrum picking. Yeah, that was such a shit joke.
The worst of it, I wasn't sure when to react because of the latency.
Oh man, you should have just reacted right away. You should have just stopped. You've made me fall now. Anyway,
what if you'd said something really somber? And then I'd laughed at it.
Yeah, like this one time I picked my nose so hard that my brain fell out. Anyway. Right, let's move on. Next question. I saw there were so many questions in the comment, and now people have just chimed in about woodworm and all kinds of different stuff. So we've got a question. What venue would you like to play at?
Ooh.
Like a bucket list, I guess.
A bucket list. That's a... I honestly don't know. I'll tell you what, Leeds Festival. I know it's not a venue, but I'd love to play at Leeds Fest. That was the first festival I went to.
And that's well good.
Yeah, that'd be the one. How about you?
I mean... I would like to play Glastonbury or Boardmasters or something like that. But I think if I was to try conquer a venue in Leeds, if it was like a hometown show, I think like the O2 or something like that, I think I'd love to play like it's a big venue, really like high energy. It demands like a large high energy audience, but it's not too like, I don't think it's too out of reach also. So like, I won't, obviously it'd be nice to say, let's play the arena, but you know, who's going to come see me? 15,000 people with 15,000 people in the arena. So.
Man, never say never.
No. But, and also I think I'd be a little scared as well.
The arena?
Be well scary, don't you think?
I reckon it'd be cool. The biggest one I ever did were like Wolverhampton City Hall. No, I've done Leeds Academy as well. The main room.
The Met. The
did O2. I not? The O2.
Have you?
Yeah. It was for ADMT because he got on that gig with Tokyo Myers.
Oh,
so
nice.
We did. It's a sick venue. It is really cool. It's weird being up there with just like a guitar and a looper.
Yeah.
But, you could do that.
That's the plan. I'm going to book it tomorrow.
Do it. I'm going to be there.
Yeah, man. Let's go. Right. I'm going to get some more questions. Do you want to play another tune?
Yeah.
How are you feeling? What have you got? Are you going to do an original?
I've not played an original for quite a long time.
Okay.
So I'm probably gonna. I'm gonna stick with the old school. Pop punky stuff.
Happy for you to do whatever. Yeah, man. 100%.
And then if we do it again, I'll rehearse some original stuff. My single is out on Friday actually as well. If I can just plug really quick.
Yeah, 100%.
Drop in the ocean. It's on there.
If you go to your Instagram and your Facebook, you'll be promoting it. So if you want to go check out Tom's Instagram and or Facebook, and he will be putting out a brand new song on Friday on Spotify.
Yeah, and every other major platform, I believe. So thank you in advance for anybody that does pre-save it. It's appreciated.
Definitely. Cool. What is this pre-save thing? I'm so living under a rock right now.
So if you pre-save a track, it basically... every pre-save accumulates as a stream on the day of release. So if you get sort of like 1,000 people to pre-save it, that straight away goes on to Spotify on that day, and that pushes it forward via the algorithms of Spotify to different playlists and like curators. And so I think it's just a way of using it to an advantage.
Yeah, that makes sense. Is that whether or not the person actually chooses to listen to it? Because doesn't it also give the person a reminder, a bit of a nudge? Oh, the song's out today.
Yeah, it'll sort of like pop up on your Spotify on the day as well.
Awesome. Oh, we'll definitely go pre-save it if now I know what that is.
Yeah, man, I think that I've explained that incredibly badly, but that's just my understanding of it.
I'm going to go with it. I think you've sold it to me. I know what it is now.
Nailed it.
First try. Right, I'll let you take it away.
They turn the lights down low, the shadows hiding from the world, only coming out when it gets cold. The seasonal patterns, they hit the floor. Voices carry on and out the door. Everything you touch turns into gold. And like the angel I left, creating a lightness in my chest.
Your eyes, they penetrate me. This is too amazing. That's when I got up and left. Beating hard in a microphone. A ticking clock in an empty home still tells of these times so long ago. And even though I've come so far, well, I know I've got so far to go. Any day now, I'll explode. And like the angel of you, I left creating a lightness in my chest. Your eyes, they penetrate. Your answers always maybe. That's when I got up and left. And each and every day will lead into tomorrow. Tomorrow brings one less day without you. But don't wait up, leave the light on. 'Cause all the roads that I might take will all one day lead back to you. I left creating a lightness in my chest. Your eyes, they penetrate me. Your answers always maybe. That's when I got up and left.
Nice work, mate.
Thank you very much. Rise Against.
Amy was saying that song takes her back. That's my wife, by the way.
Oh, yeah. It's
she was saying,
awesome tune.
It is a tune, mate. Well done. It sounds great. I forgot how good a band they are, really, to be honest.
Oh, mate, it's so good. If it takes you back to go listen to some albums, it's been worth it playing that tune.
Yeah.
It's mint, man.
Yeah, man, absolutely. I remember seeing them at, I think they did Give It a Name one year, and they were just absolutely mental. Great. Right, we've got a few questions.
Cool.
Okay, so we've got about 10 minutes left, so and I'd quite like to finish up with a song as well. So we'll just see how we get on. We did have a question, and she's asked it twice now. It was, how did you get into music? And what he wanted, did you know that this is what you wanted to do when growing up?
No, I didn't actually. I started pretty late, so just as I was leaving school, I played guitar terribly, like just learning like early Muse stuff and Blink 182 and that kind of thing. And I went into like an IT course at college. And I hated it like 3 weeks in. And I had a friend that just happened to be doing a music course in Barnsley. So I went there and that was sort of it. It was the only thing that ever interested me longer than a few weeks, I think. So.
That's insane.
Yeah, I suppose I never always knew that I wanted to do it, but it was the only thing that I ever found that I've wanted to stick at, if that makes sense.
Yeah, yeah. 100%.
Yeah, I'm pretty terrible at everything else.
Well, you're bloody talented at music, so you got to be, you got to be crap for some other stuff. You really, really are like unreal, mate. You've got an incredible voice and it's a great songwriter.
Very kind, mate. Same to you. Same to you.
Cheers, mate. That's what I was fishing for.
Oh, you don't have to fish for that, mate.
Right. Next question. Favorite song to play and why? Let's do cover and original. Have you got a favorite original and a favorite cover?
Favorite original is a track called Somebody Else off. There's an album that I've got on my Spotify called No One Home, and that's like a that was like the song that restarted me playing acoustic guitar, I suppose, because that's why I went over and did the album in the first place. So that one, I mean, I'm not even sure I can remember it, but I love playing it. And cover, probably Screaming Infidelities by Dashboard Confessional.
Brilliant.
Which is, it's dead simple. It's dead simple, but it's just loads of fun to play.
I don't... can you play it?
Yeah, just give us... Reading you over again, and there's not a word that I comprehend, except when you sign it, I will love you always and forever.
Oh, we have to go back to some Dashboard as well, mate. Honestly, between Rise Against and Dashboard, mate, you've rekindled a need to find their music again.
Good, good man. Glad to hear.
my wife said, "I feel emo again." It comes in waves, doesn't it? Really, the whole emo thing.
Yeah, it does.
Oh dear. Right, let's have. There was another question. Let's have a look. I'm sure it was around here. Oh yeah, this is a good question actually. What have you got in the pipeline after the lockdown? Are you making scheming, planning?
Yeah. Well, I've got like another 6 singles that are backdated ready to come out after this one on Friday. The pop punk one's got about 5 that's ready to come out. The first one's out on the 29th, and that's the project's called Tape Rewind Repeat, and that's going to be ongoing. Hopefully, gig at some point, but I'm going to disappear to Holland for at least a week or two and stay with a friend and just do some writing and just because he's got a great studio out there and it's a really cool space. So just change scenery, I think, is always important. And visit somewhere new. I don't know about music wise, just keep doing this. Because written a hell of a lot of music, which is great. But then obviously I think you need to have balance in your life as well. So to disappear and do something different for a bit, I think would be wicked.
I think I quite agree with you. I think during this lockdown, I think everyone's utilized their time, and especially in the music industry where it's kind of all either ground to a halt or people are going full guns blazing to try make sure that they've got, you know, some longevity for, you know, further in a future of music. But for someone like yourself and maybe even me probably a lot of other musicians out there, when lockdown's lifted, they're probably just going to want a little bit of a break because they'll have been non-stop streaming, non-stop writing, collaborations, sat in front of this desk, you know, working with people or from all over the world, that kind of stuff. But yeah, I quite agree with that. Yeah,
that were a wicked question.
Yeah, it is a good question, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right, mate, I'm going to play a song to finish up the evening, I think. Yeah. What do you want to do? Do you want to stay on screen? What do you want to do?
I'll stay on and I'll listen to you. But by all means, mate, take the front seat. Get my mug off this.
And then I'll bring you back on for any final words. So get your thinking cap on.
Will do.
Right, so Paula, if you're still here. drop a comment. Thanks so much, guys, for watching tonight. We're not quite over yet. I'm going to play a song and then bring Tom on for some final words. But yeah, I do this every single night. If you're new here, please consider subscribing to the channel. And if Paula is still here, this one is for her. You say I love you, boy. I know you lie. I trust you all the same. I don't know why. 'Cause when my back is turned, my bruises shine. My fairy tales are so hard to find.
Yes, mate. Thanks, mate. Sounded wicked.
Cheers, dude. Been practicing, haven't I? Mate, thank you so much for joining me tonight, man. I really appreciate you coming on and sounding incredible as ever. And I'm really looking forward to your new song coming out. So Friday, if you haven't already, head over to your Spotify channel and pre-save Tom's new song, which is coming out Friday, correct?
Yeah, man. That's it.
Which you'll find on your socials, which are on screen.
Oi. There it goes. Nah, mate, thank you for having us. Thank you for asking. And yeah, it's always good just to have a chat. Yeah, play some tunes. It's good.
Honestly,
man, enjoyed it.
Like I say, you've made me want to go check out some old nostalgic bands. And also, I definitely will take you up on that offer about collaborating, if not featuring on one of your pop punk songs, man. I'd love
it. Mate, do it. I'll link you a couple of the MP3s on WhatsApp.
Yes.
See if you're game for it. I reckon you will.
Mate. Yes, mate. Definitely down. Right. All right, man. I'm going to sign off. Once again, thank you so much for joining me tonight, man. And I'll speak to you very soon. All right.
Yeah, man. Take care of yourself and everybody else. Hope they're keeping well in a bit.
See you, dude. Thank you so much, guys, for tuning in to another live stream here at Assembly Point. And I'm so grateful for this continued support. And yeah, it's been a good one tonight. There was a few technical issues. Hopefully we got through it. And please do go to either of these social platforms that are on the screen now and pre-save Tom's new song. And also, finally, as well, for those of you that are on Spotify, let me just get rid of this a sec. For those of you that are on Spotify, please head over to the Spotify playlist that I've put on Facebook. I'm now going to start featuring all of the artists that I've had on previously and up to now, and in the future, we'll be going on an Assembly Point guests playlist. Make sure you pre-save. Now I've heard the word pre-save, I think that's just a thing for everything now, but it's not. What's the word? How does Spotify work? Do you like and follow? I don't know. Anyway, go to the Spotify playlist and go support all of the artists that I've put in there. And finally, if you're new here, please subscribe. If you have already subscribed, thank you very much for the continued support. And yeah, I'll see you all tomorrow. I do this every single day at 7 p.m.